Hi, everyone. How are you doing? First of all, short question. Who of you have ever need to use a non-React component, UI component, in a React application? OK, so I will be talking about approaching this idea, how to reactify your existing UI components to use them in a React application. I have been working as a front-end developer for many years, and currently I'm working as a software engineer at Accenture. So we all know that React is a component-based library for building user interfaces that has no pre-built components. But on the other hand, there is a lot of great, awesome components developed by different teams and companies over the last, like, 15 years. And components were developed by internal teams or third-party teams. Who of you already have a UI component, not React components, that you would like to use in React applications? These components use the requirements, and you like it. OK, just a few. So I have good news for you. Existing components could be reused. You may wonder why components specially developed as React components is the best option for React application. And technically, it's true. I agree. But in an ideal world, in a real world, all companies, all teams always have limited time, limited resources, and they need to achieve a goal within a fixed time frame and within a fixed budget. So why you would need to reuse existing components in a React application in a real world? Because your components provides all requested features, because there is no similar React component available on the market, and because rewriting your existing component as a React component would require a lot of time and effort. So a bit of background, how did we come to this idea and decided to solve this issue? Our main product is EXEJS library JavaScript framework, and it includes a lot of UI components. So the reasonable question was, like, why would we not make these components available for React users? And we decided to Reactify them and make it possible to use them in a React application. So as an implementation of this idea, we have developed an open source tool called XJS Reactor that allows to use EXEJS components in React application. I will talk about general way of doing this, but with some examples from Reactor. So basic concept, just a simple wrapper that will create EXEJS component or your component under the hood, and it will constructor of this wrapper will take props from React, state from React, and then transform them and create EXEJS configs. Then there is it will translate React method calls into EXEJS method calls, and it will also fire React events that correspond to EXEJS event, and it provides a link to underlying EXEJS component. So, but this wrapper, it's just a starting point. The most interesting task is to embed EXEJS component or any other UI component in a React components hierarchy. There is a simplest React component hierarchy, and wrapper should allow us to add third-party component not only as a leaf component, but it should be also possible to add standard React components as children to our component. So how could you implement this? First, Reactify functions that takes any EXEJS component type and return class that will extend EXEJS component. EXEJS component is a it's wrapper itself. It extends React component class. It provides its constructor will take props and create underlying EXEJS component. It will return this component as output of get public instance function. It will also have methods that will translate React method calls into EXTJS method calls, and it will implement all magic inside of component did mount, component did update functions, and so on. So inside of these functions, you could have call methods of XRenderer, and XRenderer will implement methods of React Reconciler. All this create instance, append initial child, append child, and other functions, and all real magic will happen here. These functions will be responsible for actually embedding component, EXTJS component in the React component hierarchy. And that's it. How could you use your Reactified components? First, you import any component like grid from your package, and transpiler, for our case, transpiler will transpile this line of code into two lines. First, we import Reactify function, and then we Reactify our grid or any other component. And after this, you just directly use grid or like column component directly into render function. There is a simple example of grid with two columns. And as a bit more interesting example, I would like to show you a Reactified grid component that shows more than 2 million rows in a browser. So I will refresh, and there is row number a column, and I will start scrolling. More than 1 million, more than 2 million. So it's just simply Reactified component. Oops. The source code, just grid with several columns. And inside of row, you could add React component. So to play with this, you could check our GitHub repo. And if you would like to know more about this approach or would like to see more examples, please let me know. I'm super happy to talk. Okay.